So hey guys, this is the circuit again, and this is basically version 1, let's say, of the project. What I've done here is I've hooked up yesterday's circuit to the Arduino. Okay, and for the demo here I won't be using this underwater because we've already seen that the sensing part of it works. We saw that yesterday. So I'm just going to connect this directly to the Arduino, and to just test it I'm just going to basically, you know, make these two cables touch, okay, to make these two wires touch, and it's the same thing as the water passing around, passing through. So I'm using an Arduino this time because I'm more familiar with it, so I just thought I'd write some rough code for it, and I can just directly port this code to the MSP430 using the Energia platform. Okay, so what you'll see here is I've connected this blue wire, and this blue wire is basically the output of the sensor, and what I'm going to do is read this output, and there'll be some code. You can see this code. I mean, okay, you can't see the code here, but I'll send it to you in the mail. This code will basically run, and it'll turn on a small LED whenever the sensors are touching each other. And of course, I've done little bit of extra work that, you know, I wait for some time, and then turn on the LEDs, and the LED blinking speeds up as if the wires are not disconnected. Okay, and you'll see all this happening very fast. That's because I just did that to make the video short. They're all variables, so I'll write comments, and you can just change some numbers over there, and you know, you can make the LED blink faster, you can make the LED blink slower, you can wait even longer for the LEDs to start blinking. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to reset the Arduino. Okay, just so that we start from the beginning, and I will connect these wires together. So just give me a minute. Okay. Now if you see here, after some time, the LED, okay, you can see that the LED started blinking, and you will slowly see that the LED blinks faster and faster and faster and faster. So that basically simulates that, you know, that you not close the tap at all, and you could convert this blinking faster into probably a speaker which is going louder, or anything you want. The main thing is I'm able to sense the water is running, and I'm able to do something about it. I'm able to indicate it somehow. Okay, and that's the main part. And so if I disconnect it over here, okay, if I just disconnect it over here, give me a second. You can see that the LED stopped blinking, and if I reconnect it, should start blinking again. Okay, and the same thing happens again. Okay, so that's it for this demo.